Hello everyone! In today's tutorial, I will guide you step by step on how to install the final version of macOS 14 Sonoma. Please note that this is not a beta version. I will use a MacBook Pro M1 and a Samsung External SSD T7 for this demonstration. However, the installation process remains the same if you install macOS Sonoma on an internal drive. It is always recommended to back up your Mac in advance to avoid any potential data loss. I have already created a separate volume for this purpose. It will be a clean install. A clean install is the best option for upgrading your operating system. It reduces many problems during and after the installation. I have already downloaded the installation package, and I will leave the link in the description box below this video if you decide to download it. The file size is slightly over 12 gigabytes. To start, I'll double-click the Install Assistant Installer and click Continue. This will take 40.8 MB of space on your computer. Click Install to perform a standard installation of this software on the disk Macintosh HD. I don't want to install it on my Macintosh HD. Therefore, I'll click Change Install Location, select the macOS Sonoma volume on my Samsung SSD, then click Continue. And after that, I'll click Install. Enter my password and click Install Software. Installer would like to access files on a removable volume. I'll click OK. After closing the window, I'll open macOS Sonoma volume and double-click Install macOS Sonoma. And then I'll click Continue. An internet connection is required to install macOS. I'll click OK. In the following step, I click Agree, Show all disks, and select macOS Sonoma volume, and then click Continue. On the next screen, you will see your username asking if you want to copy your account settings. For the purpose of this tutorial, I won't select this option. Instead, I'll click Install. Enter my password and click Unlock to start the installation. At this stage, patience is required. As displayed on the screen, it reads, the installation takes about 3 hours and 4 minutes. However, on my Samsung SSD, it took only 1 hour. Then you need to restart. During the installation, a black screen with the Apple logo and a progress bar appeared 4 times before displaying the initial setup screen where you need to choose your country. If you don't have time and decide to set up your macOS later, press Command plus Q to shut down your Mac and continue whenever you can. Otherwise, select your country. If you don't see your country's name, scroll down to find it and click Continue. Next, you will see the written and spoken languages. In my case, it's English and Japanese. If you want to add another language, click Customize Settings, Add a language, and click Continue. The next screen is Accessibility. Accessibility features adapt your Mac to your individual needs. You can do this later in the system settings. To simplify the process, click Not Now. On the following screen, you will need to select your network. In my case, I use a Wi-Fi network, so I choose my Wi-Fi name from the list and enter my password, or select your wired network and enter your password. After connecting to the internet, you will see the data and privacy screen. If you want more information, click Learn More. Otherwise, click Continue. The following screen is Migration Assistant. If you have data on another Mac or a Windows PC, you can transfer it to this Mac. I prefer not to do it now, so I click Not Now. The next step is to sign in with your Apple ID to use iCloud, the Apple Store, and other Apple services. Enter your Apple ID, which is your email address, and enter the password for your Apple ID in this box. If you don't want to do it now, click Setup Later. Then click Continue. You will receive a 6-digit verification code. I received the code on my iPhone. Enter the code and click Continue. The next screen will display the terms and conditions in your language. After reading them, make sure the checkbox on the left is selected and click Agree. The following prompt is for creating a computer account or user account. Enter your full name or just your first name. Your name will be used for your account name. Next, enter your password and verify it by entering it again. This password will be used each time you log into your Mac. The password hint is optional, but you can enter anything in this box if you would like. For example, you could say, "I love strawberries." Please write down your user or account name, password, and password hint, and keep them in a safe place. You need this information every time you log in to your Mac. In the next step, iCloud will be used to set up your account. The process takes a short time, so please be patient and click Continue. The following screen is Make This Your New Mac. If you are happy with your settings, click on Continue. If you want to change some of these settings, click Customize Settings. I am satisfied with the settings, so I click Continue. Regarding the Touch ID, if you wish, you can use your fingerprint to unlock your Mac by placing your finger or thumb on the Touch ID sensor. I don't use this feature, so I click Setup Touch ID Later. You will see the Sonoma desktop if everything goes smoothly without any issues. If you wish to change any settings on your Mac, click System Settings to customize your Mac. I will be posting more tutorials on some of these settings in the near future. I hope you learned something new today. If you did, please consider subscribing by clicking on the LT Lucid Tutorials logo and sharing the video link with your friends. Your support will inspire me to create more videos for you. Thank you for watching.